Today we are back at designing 100 sheds in Stardew Valley. Yes, it's been a while, I know, I'm lazy, okay? If you haven't already, check out the previous episodes of me designing 100 sheds, link is in the description. Okay, enough talk, let's begin. Do you love reading books? Then this one is for you. A library. It's a pretty basic one overall, I kept a dark theme. We have a bunch of computers and loads of books. This one is called the chess room. I love to play chess, so that's where I got the idea. You can invite a friend over at your farm and then challenge them to play chess and see who wins. Also, the winner gets mares on these. Priceless, I know. Okay, let's start kicking in the requests from you guys. First up, this dude wanted me to do a shed based on Shane. They also asked for a house, which I have already done, so let's do the shed real quick. Okay, so in this one, I made a little coop, a little seating area, and the pepper heaven. Okay, a fellow wanted to see a confectionery shop, so I made one to the best of my capabilities. Low-key proud of this. We have the counter and lots of sweets. You might want to alert your beta cells before visiting this place. Get it? Our next suggestion comes from the same person who suggested the pyre in a hut. This time they were looking for a grayish prison for the weird statues, so I made one. Here we have 5 different cells. The first prisoner is a witch. He gets a trash can, a cubby, a chest, and some noodles. The second prisoner is, wait, who's that? Shrek? Anyway, he gets a Jojo Cola. The third prisoner is a bunny, and I must warn you, don't fall for that innocent face, okay? The fourth prisoner is Tin Man. He gets a TV because he's rich. And lastly, we have Pinky Lemon. She's a Yoba believer. Back to JulieB00. This time I'm making the Crobus room and the Trash Bear inspired room. First up we have the Crobus room. It has a lot of void eggs as you can see and overall a pretty dark vibe, my sweet child. Next we have the Trash Bear inspired room. That's the big guy in the center. And I've also displayed a bunch of things he requests for. The right side has the summer items and the left side has the spring items. We also have a lot of trash scattered around which will be cleaned after we complete the quest. And that wraps up the requests from you guys. If you have any ideas, let me know in the comments. Cookies and cream. It's basically a storage shed, but instead of a plain and boring storage shed, I made an Oreo cookie. And not sure if you can tell, but this is the upper cookie, the cream in the middle, and the bottom cookie. Looks great at night, a must have on your farm. Are you a hat collector in Stardew Valley? Then I've got just the shed for you. I call this Hats with a Z. As you can see, it's loaded with hats. These are all the hats you can get in Stardew Valley. So buckle up and start collecting if you haven't already. Let's be real, who doesn't love cheese? So here is a shed to make some tasty cheese. I call this the Dairy Shack. It's a functional shed, as you can see. We have some cheese presses and a lot of greenery. It's functional and cute. I made the most iconic coffee house to ever exist, Central Perk. I tried my best to recreate the actual one. Let's imagine the door is located somewhere around here. That's the iconic sitting area. Here we have some tables, a counter space for Gunther. Here we have an area for Phoebe to play her amazing music.
Smelly cat!
Also, let me clarify if you haven't noticed, this is Joey and he's wearing his Porsche hat. That's Monica with the chef hat and Chandler. And if you're wondering where Ross and Rachel are, they're on a break. I call this Campfire Under the Stars. It's a night exclusive design, has a lot of aesthetic to it. Somebody in the comments of the house design videos actually asked me how I made this pond. You need to make a square shaped boundary using grass and in between place an icy rug. If you want a smaller pond, you can replace the icy rug with an oceanic rug. And that's pretty much it. This one is made by my friend. She originally made it in her co-op farm and she was so proud of it and wanted me so badly to include it in the video. So here you go, I hope you're happy. It's called Fish and Chill. It's basically something to showcase the joys of fishing in Stardew Valley. Are you lonely in Stardew Valley and have no friends who can serve you a cup of coffee? That's okay, present to you the Slimy Cafe. As you can see, it is run by slimes. You can just come here, place your order, and we are good to go. Problem solved. Funnies apart, I'm legit so proud of how this one turned out. This one is called Shipwreck. It's a ship that got wrecked. These are the remains of a ship deep under the water. We have some fish living inside of it, a literal human skeleton, and a skull. We also have a treasure chest, and since I'm the one who found it, I'm rich. Are you fond of baking in real life? Then this one is for you. The Spring Bake Sale. Set this up once every year and I'm sure the villagers of Pelican Town will love your cakes. And also, you will be rich in no time. Just like me. As you can see, this one has a lot of flowers going on. Overall, giving that spring feel. I present to you Professor Snail's field office. We can also call it his dream shed. This one is pretty self-explanatory. As you can see, we have a lot of fossils here and there. Are you tired of dying a bazillion times in the skull cavern? I know what you need. A spa and sauna to relax your nerves. Here we have some seating and a hot jacuzzi. Relaxing indeed. I call this Abigail's training room. Yep, that rock-eating dragon needs to polish her skills if she wants to step in the mines to look for food. You can make this on your farm if you're married to her. I'm sure she'll love it. I call this science. If you can't tell, this is basically the Jesse we need to cook recreation from Unsurpassable Z's video. I love the series Breaking Bad, so I had to make this. As you can see, we have a huge meth lab, that's Heisenberg, and that's Mr. White's glasses. Have you ever wondered what's inside this little hut? I present to you the inside of a Junimo hut. We have some Junimos according to the color of their gemstones. There are also some harvested crops that the farmer forgot to pick up. We have the mini desert recreation. I did a mini Ginger Island recreation in the previous video, so today I thought about doing a desert one. Let's break it down. This is Sandy's shop, the Oasis, with the bouncer as well. This is a hint towards the Skull Caverns, Sweet Iridium. These are the three pillars from where you get the Galaxy Sword. That's the Desert Trader and some cactus fruits and palm trees. I added an end table with the coconut behind the palm trees, so it looks like the coconuts are on the palm trees. I don't know if it makes any sense, but yeah. This video will be uploaded around the time of Christmas, or if I'm lazy, it will be uploaded in 2024. Who knows? But anyway, it's a Christmas special. Here we have an outdoor garden, some snowmen and candy canes. I used the wooden panels to separate the indoors. Here we have a fireplace and some stockings, a huge Christmas tree, and tons of presents. Even if this video is uploaded late, happy holidays everybody! Pixel art time. At this point, it's now a tradition basically in every video to make one pixel art. So yeah, I will give you 5 seconds to guess, okay? This looks so horrible and I love it. So proud. I hope you enjoyed. Subscribe for more. See you soon.